Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night, when our Lord Jesus Christ passed from death to life, the Church invites her children throughout the world to come together in vigil and prayer. This is the Passover of the Lord. If we honor the memory of his death and resurrection by hearing his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we may be confident that we shall share his victory over death and live with him forever in God. Hermanos, en esta noche santa, en que nuestro Señor Jesucristo ha pasado de la muerte a la vida, la Iglesia invita a todos sus hijos diseminados por el mundo a que se reúnan para velar en oración. Si recordamos así la Pascua del Señor, oyendo su palabra y celebrando sus misterios, podremos esperar tener parte en su triunfo sobre la muerte y vivir con él siempre en Dios.
Christian believers apart from worldly vices and Reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus, evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth. And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the waters of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground. I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it to be very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
As a garment you covered it, above the mountains the waters stood. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. You send forth springs into the watercourses that wind among the mountains. Beside them the birds of heaven dwell. From among the branches they send forth their song. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. You water the mountains from your palace. The earth is replete with the fruit of your word. You raise grass for the cattle and vegetation for man's use, producing bread from the earth. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. How manifold are your works, O you have brought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Let us pray. Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, admirable siempre en todas tus obras, que tus redimidos comprendan cómo la creación del mundo en el comienzo de los siglos no fue obra de mayor grandeza que el sacrificio pascual de Cristo en la plenitud de los tiempos. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amén.
Lectura del libro del Éxodo. En aquellos días, dijo el Señor a Moisés, ¿por qué sigues clamando a mí? Diles a los israelitas que se pongan en marcha. Y tú, alza tu bastón, extiende tu mano sobre el mar y divídelo para que los israelitas entren en el mar sin mojarse. Yo voy a endurecer el corazón de los egipcios para que los persigan y me cubriré de gloria a expensas del faraón y de todo su ejército, de sus carros y jinetes. Cuando me haya cubierto de gloria a expensas del faraón, de sus carros y jinetes, los egipcios sabrán que yo soy el Señor. El ángel del Señor, que iba al frente de las huestes de Israel, se colocó tras ellas, y la columna de nubes que iba adelante también se desplazó y se puso a sus espaldas, entre el campamento de los israelitas y el campamento de los egipcios. La nube era tiniebla para unos y claridad para los otros. Y así los ejércitos no trabaron contacto durante la noche. Moisés extendió la mano sobre el mar y el Señor hizo soplar durante toda la noche un fuerte viento del este que secó el mar y dividió las aguas. Los israelitas entraron en el mar y no se mojaban, mientras las aguas formaban una muralla a su derecha y a su izquierda. Los egipcios se lanzaron en su persecución y toda la caballería del faraón, sus carros, jinetes, entraron tras ellos en el mar. Hacia el amanecer, el Señor miró desde la columna de fuego y humo al ejército de los egipcios y sembró entre ellos el pánico. Trabó las ruedas de sus carros, de suerte que no avanzaban sino pesadamente. Dijeron entonces los egipcios, huyamos de Israel, porque el Señor lucha en su favor contra Egipto. Entonces el Señor le dijo a Moisés, extiende tu mano sobre el mar para que vuelvan las aguas sobre los egipcios, sus carros y sus jinetes. Y extendió Moisés su mano sobre el mar, y al amanecer las aguas volvieron a su sitio, de suerte que al huir los egipcios se encontraron con ellas, y el Señor los derribó en medio del mar. Volvieron las aguas y cubrieron a carros, jinetes y a todo el ejército del faraón, que se había metido en el mar para perseguir a Israel. Ni uno solo se salvó, pero los hijos de Israel caminaban por lo seco en medio del mar. Las aguas les hacían muralla a derecha e izquierda. Aquel día salvó el Señor a Israel de las manos de Egipto. Israel vio a los egipcios muertos en la orilla del mar. Israel vio la mano fuerte del Señor sobre los egipcios, y el pueblo temió al Señor y creyó en el Señor y en Moisés, su siervo. Entonces Moisés y los hijos de Israel cantaron este cántico al Señor.
Cantemos al Señor, sublime su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, sublime su victoria. Cantemos al Señor, sublime su victoria. Caballo y jinete arrojado en el mar. Fuerza y mi poder es el Señor, Él fue mi salvación. Él es mi Dios, yo lo alabaré. El Dios de mis padres, yo lo ensalzaré. Cantemos al Señor, sublime su victoria.
Father, even today we see the wonders of the miracles you worked long ago. You once saved a single nation from slavery, and now you offer that salvation to all through baptism. May the people of the world become true sons and daughters of Abraham and prove worthy of the heritage of Israel. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run to you. Because of the Lord, your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God who is generous and forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving the seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Holy One of Israel.
Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, esperanza única del mundo, que anunciaste por la voz de tus profetas los misterios de los tiempos presentes, atiende a los deseos de tu pueblo, porque ninguno de tus fieles puede progresar en la virtud sin la inspiración de tu gracia, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amén. With the radiance of the risen Christ, quicken the spirit of daughter and sonship in your church, renew us in mind and body to give you wholehearted service. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Romanos. Hermanos, todos los que hemos sido incorporados a Cristo Jesús por medio del bautismo, hemos sido incorporados a su muerte. En efecto, por el bautismo fuimos sepultados con él en su muerte, para que así como Cristo resucitó de entre los muertos por la gloria del Padre, así también nosotros llevemos una vida nueva. Porque si hemos estado íntimamente unidos a Él por una muerte semejante a la suya, también lo estaremos en su resurrección. Sabemos que nuestro viejo yo fue crucificado con Cristo, para que el cuerpo del pecado quedara destruido, a fin de que ya no sirvamos al pecado, pues él ha muerto, queda libre del pecado. Por lo tanto, si hemos muerto con Cristo, estamos seguros de que también viviremos con él, pues sabemos que Cristo, una vez resucitado de entre los muertos, ya nunca morirá. La muerte ya no tiene dominio sobre él, porque al morir, murió el pecado de una vez y para siempre. Y al resucitar, vive ahora para Dios. Lo mismo ustedes, considérense muertos al pecado y vivos para Dios, en Cristo Jesús, Señor nuestro. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, 'He has been raised from the dead, and he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you.' Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached and embraced his feet and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, 'Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me.' Transcurrido el sábado, el amanecer del primer día de la semana, María Magdalena y la otra María fueron a ver el sepulcro. De pronto se produjo un gran temblor, porque el ángel del Señor bajó del cielo y acercándose al sepulcro hizo rodar la piedra que lo tapaba y se sentó sobre ella. Su rostro brillaba como el relámpago, y sus vestiduras eran blancas como la nieve. Los guardias, atemorizados ante él, se pusieron a temblar y se quedaron como muertos. El ángel se dirigió a las mujeres y les dijo, 'No teman. Ya sé que buscan a Jesús el crucificado. No está aquí. Ha resucitado como lo había dicho. Vengan a ver el lugar donde lo habían puesto. Y ahora vayan deprisa a decir a sus discípulos, "Ha resucitado de entre los muertos, e irá delante de ustedes a Galilea. Allá lo verán. Eso es todo." Ellas se alejaron a toda prisa del sepulcro y llenas de temor y de gran alegría corrieron a dar la noticia a los discípulos. Pero de repente Jesús les salió al encuentro y las saludó. Ellas se acercaron, le abrazaron los pies y lo adoraron. Entonces les dijo Jesús, no tengan miedo, vayan a decir a mis hermanos que se dirijan a Galilea, allá me verán. Palabra del Señor. Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús. En esta noche solemne de luz, damos gracias a Dios por el gran don de la vida eterna que hemos recibido por medio de su Hijo Jesucristo. Hoy celebramos la victoria de Cristo sobre el pecado y la muerte. Velemos, pues, con nuestro Señor, por medio de su Iglesia, durante este tiempo de pandemia, con fe y con amor. El esplendor de esta noche de Pascua ilumina los corazones de todos los fieles. Unámonos, pues, a esta celebración de la victoria de Cristo, para que un día podamos compartir la gloria de una semejante resurrección. On this solemn night of light, we give thanks to God for the great gift of eternal life which we have received through His Son, Jesus Christ. Tonight we celebrate the victory of Christ over sin and death as we keep watch with Christ and Holy Mother Church during this pandemic in faith and in great love. The splendor of this Paschal night illumines the hearts of all the faithful. Let us join then in the celebration of the victory of Christ so that one day we too might share in the glory of a like resurrection. Hemos pasado por el misterio pascual. Ahora vamos a renovar nuestras promesas bautismales. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ. Let us now walk with Him in newness of life and renew our baptismal promises. Renuncian a Satanás. Do you reject Satan? Sí, I do. Y todas sus obras.
I do.
And all his works. I do. Y a todas sus seducciones. And all his empty promises. I do. Creen en Dios Padre Todopoderoso, Creador del cielo y de la tierra. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth? I do. Creen en Jesucristo, su único Hijo, nuestro Señor, que nació de Santa María Virgen, murió, fue sepultado, resucitó de entre los muertos y está sentado a la derecha del Padre. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? I do. Creen en el Espíritu Santo, en la Santa Iglesia Católica, en la comunión de los santos, en el perdón de los pecados, en la resurrección de los muertos, y en la vida eterna. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, in the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? I do. Dios Todopoderoso, Padre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, nos guarde hasta la vida eterna. May God, the all-powerful Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep us faithful to eternal life. Let us now turn to the Lord to offer our petitions.
For our Holy Father and all believers, that their faith in the resurrection make them joyful messengers of salvation.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Jerusalem's God in us. Send your
por los líderes de la comunidad, por los predicadores y maestros, para que continúen compartiendo la buena nueva de la resurrección de Jesús.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
For all those who have not heard or who have not believed, that their hearts may be stirred by the example of those who proclaim the risen Lord.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos.
Por los miembros de esta comunidad eucarística, para que profundicen en su conocimiento del misterio pascual.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For those most affected by the pandemic, doctors, nurses, first responders, police officers, and caregivers, for those who have lost their lives, and for their grieving families. Por los más afectados en esta pandemia, por los doctores, enfermeras, personal de emergencia, policías, y todo aquel que presta cuidados a otros. Por aquellos que han perdido sus vidas, y por sus familias.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
For an increase of vocations to the religious life and to the priesthood, por un aumento de vocaciones a la vida religiosa y la vida sacerdotal.
We pray for the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Deus exaudinos. Señor, escúchanos.
Dios de vida, escucha nuestras súplicas, concédenos lo que pedimos en tu nombre. God of life and resurrection, grant all these things through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Oren mis hermanas y hermanos. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Glory in his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
En verdad es justo y necesario, es nuestro deber y salvación, glorificarte siempre, Señor, pero más que nunca en esta noche en que Cristo nuestra Pascua fue inmolado, porque Él es el verdadero Cordero que quitó el pecado del mundo. Muriendo destruyó nuestra muerte y resucitando restauró la vida. Por eso con esta efusión del gozo pascual, el mundo entero se desborda de alegría y también los coros celestiales, los ángeles y los arcángeles cantan sin cesar. El himno de tu gloria.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis Angelii et terra gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Mortem tuam annuntiamus Domine, et tuam resurrectionem confitemur. Domine.
Así pues, Padre, al celebrar ahora el memorial de la muerte y resurrección de tu Hijo, te ofrecemos el pan de vida y el cáliz de salvación. Y te damos gracias porque nos haces dignos de servirte en tu presencia. Te pedimos humildemente que el Espíritu Santo congregue en la unidad a cuantos participamos del cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her most chaste spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, Saint Patrick, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Démonos fraternalmente una señal de la paz. Let us give to one another the peace of Christ.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei,
Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos los invitados a la cena del Señor. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. En este momento, al recibir a nuestro Señor espiritualmente, damos gracias al Señor por todos los beneficios y bendiciones que ha derramado sobre nosotros en nuestra vida. En estos tiempos tan inseguros, tenemos la seguridad del amor de Dios y de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. At this time of spiritual communion, we give thanks to Almighty God for the many blessings that the Lord bestows upon us in this life. In these unsure times, we have the surety, the confidence, and love of our Lord, both in Holy Communion and in the Holy Spirit and in the grace of God. And for this we give thanks. Always close to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. What a blessing. Unidos al Sagrado Corazón de Jesús. Qué bendición. Let us pray. Oremos. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Derrama sobre nosotros tu espíritu de caridad, para que vivamos siempre unidos en tu amor. Lord, make us one in peace and love. We ask you this through Christ our Lord. Amen. On behalf of all the staff here at St. Patrick, we extend to each and every one of you our wishes for a very blessed and safe Easter. De parte del personal de la parroquia de San Patricio, les deseamos a todos ustedes unos deseos para una feliz y bendecida Pascua del Señor. Podéis ir en paz. The Mass is ended. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
blessing of Almighty God, Padre, Hijo, y Espíritu Santo, descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.